Building the wooden and concrete structures that support Army operations on and off the battlefield is a vital component in assuring the well-being of soldiers and maintaining military readiness. Creating and maintaining these structures is the primary responsibility of the carpentry and masonry specialist.
We're usually the first ones on the ground, so people come to base camps and they see these sea huts and they see all the things that are going on around, but they don't understand the engineers. We were there first.
In this military occupational specialty, your duties may include the construction of trusses and other structural assemblies, performing basic construction mathematics with a knowledge of basic building materials, forming and reinforcing concrete floors and foundations, framing floors, walls, and roofs to assist in a variety of construction engineer missions. By the end of training, you should be able to construct a 100 square foot building.
Getting that hammer and nail and putting that wall together, it's rewarding. You kind of sit back and realize, yes, I literally made this, and it's a structure, like, you can live in it.
Candidates for this MOS should include individuals who are interested in creating and building structures, who enjoy math, working outdoors, and using hand and power tools, have the ability to work as a member of a team while maintaining safety awareness, and are physically and mentally fit to perform strenuous work under pressure. After successfully completing Army basic combat training, you will attend 7 weeks of advanced individual training at the Naval Construction Training Center in Gulfport, Mississippi, where you'll be training alongside other Armed Forces personnel.
Teaching with the Army, Navy, and Air Force, I see that as a positive thing. We all deploy with them and work together, so it's good to actually see that we're training to the exact same standards.
During your training, you'll learn how to interpret construction drawings and read blueprints, the basics in concrete technology, materials, and proportioning, the proper use of a variety of hand tools, power tools, and construction equipment, concrete placing, consolidation, and finishing, along with edging, jointing, and curing, and the basics in wooden structure framing, roofing, and flooring. After successful completion of training, you'll work supporting Army operations with a construction engineer unit in the field and around the world. While there are destinations to which the Army is sent for combat purposes, it also travels around the world building schools, medical clinics, and other public buildings in countries where our assistance is needed.
Honduras, I've been to Germany, Iraq, Afghanistan, and not only have I been there, but able to go and put my stamp on those countries. We built schools, roads, and this job has definitely helped me to be a part of something much bigger than myself.
These skills and others you will learn, such as teamwork and discipline, may help you transition from the military to the civilian workforce, where you may find employment in the construction career field or with further education and certifications in the engineering fields. Carpentry and Masonry Specialist, a crucial member of the Army Engineer Regiment. SAONS.